This is a fish that is dangerous.
It's a lot bigger than I thought.
And if this video does 750 likes,
trying to find some kind of man-eating catfish.
Hi there. My name is Zach, and this is SC Fish Keeping, and today I'm here to tell you that I have a catfish problem. And it all began with this guy. This guy, of course, is none other than my gulper catfish. And the gulper catfish was actually the first fish that I ever posted on my channel. Hello, YouTube. I wanted to take this time to make a quick little video on my newest addition to my fish keeping hobby. This is my gulper catfish. He was the first real catfish that I ever bought. And apparently, he started me on this path to a catfish addiction. In today's video, it doesn't get any better. I made it way worse. I have a lot of catfish. I mean, I joke, but I really do. So giving you the speed rundown of all my catfish, you can never see them, but back in the 125, there is a black wallago catfish and a Lima shovel nose catfish with just one eye. Hiding out down here, you can probably see him there. There. Is my baby brown bullhead. There is also the wild-caught yellow bullhead down in there. Switching rooms. Hiding out back in the corner, you can also never see him, is the wild-caught channel catfish. Used to be in here with the smallmouth bass, now over there with the smallmouth bass. Down here in this little bottom tank, I have two tiger shovel nose. And then, I'm talking to someone about trying to find some kind of man-eating catfish that'll go in here. But with all these catfish that I already have, it really just leads a person to ask, can you ever have too many catfish? No, you simply can never have too many catfish. So that's why today we're at my local fish store, one of my favorite places to buy fish. And we're getting something a little different, something unlike any other catfish that I've ever had. And honestly, the whole situation started because they called me and said, we can get you one, do you want it? I said, heck yes. So let's go inside, I'll show you around, show you some of the stuff they have, and then I'll show you what we are taking home. Breathe in the air, the light that surrounds me. If we hold ourselves together, we'll go far. Created a space. In my head it was empty, but I know that I want to be where you are. I was denied. I had spent those years, did not recognize the person that's inside. So yeah, so as you guys can tell, there are tons of really, really cool, a lot of unique fish. A lot of monster fish. Some of the stuff that I really enjoy. But if you guys are in the Omaha area or around it, definitely come check this place out. They're always getting new stuff. I get a lot of people ask me what's the best way to buy fish, and I don't think many people know that your local fish store, places like this, can order you special fish. Anything you want, you can ask. And if their supplier has it, they can bring it in, saves you on the shipping, and you know, you support your local fish store at the same time. So definitely, if you want a unique fish like this, start with checking out your local fish store. Or if you're around Omaha, call Fish Freaks. But this fish is actually in the back. Let's go check it out. So, they actually already brought it up front for me, so it's big, it's in the bag. I gave you a little teaser, but any guesses? Anybody have any idea before I show you exactly what it is, what I bought? But we'll get it home, we'll get it in the tank, and then I'll show you more. It's a lot bigger than I thought. So, I don't know if you guys have guessed it down in the comments yet, but this guy right here is what's known as an electric catfish. And the title was not joking. This is a fish that is dangerous. It is a fish that can electrocute you. It is not for the faint of heart, literally. And it is not something that should be kept by anything less than an experienced hobbyist because, well, he acclimates. Let me just tell you a little bit more at the whiteboard. So yeah, pretty cool monster, super unique fish that you just don't see every day. And that's one of my favorite kind of fish to buy and be able to share with you are things that you don't see at your everyday fish store, that you don't see in the everyday hobbyist fish room. And this monster is gonna give us some awesome content feedings, and it's just something I'm super happy to have. He's definitely ready to get out of this bag. And you'll notice I'm just gonna dump him in there with the water in his tank. He's the only thing going into this tank. It's kind of like a quarantine tank for him. It's definitely not a forever home. With him being the only thing in there, I'm not worried about any kind of cross-contamination or anything like that. So let's just go ahead and drop him in there. And then we'll watch him swim. Now, I know what you're thinking, because I'm thinking it, we're all thinking it. What does it feel like to get shocked by an electric catfish? I gave you a few of the little stats. An adult, full grown, supposedly can knock out a human. So this is obviously not an adult. He's got some growing to go, so right now it maybe feels like a tingle, maybe it's a little stronger. But I'm here to educate. And what kind of educator would I be if I didn't stick my hand in there to get shocked? But I'm gonna need a little something from you guys at home if you want me to just go ahead and stick my hand into a tank with a potentially harmful, deadly fish. So right now, go down below, hit that thumbs up, and if this video does 750 likes, it's a tall ask because I really don't wanna stick my hand in there. So yeah, so 750 likes, I'll stick my hand in there, but I just wanna kind of specify here. I'm not gonna stick my hand in there and like grab him and potentially stress him out, because I never want to do anything that's gonna harm my fish just for content. I'm gonna try and hand feed it. I already kind of covered how they like to shock their prey and kind of stun them. So what I'll do is I'll maybe move him to a smaller container or something, and I'll try and stick my hand in there to hand feed him and see if we can't get a shock reaction, and we'll go from there. So 750 likes, we'll hand feed this electric catfish and see what it does to me. So obviously he's still a little shy, which is to be expected. I put some food in there, and I'm sure it'll be gone once I turn the lights off. I have read that they do get more comfortable and less nocturnal, especially when food is presented to them. So we will be getting some cool feedings and stuff with him in the future. And I'm serious about doing that 750 likes for a zap, but in a way that doesn't stress the fish out. Like I said, just want to reiterate that, because YouTube views should never come over the safety or the care of the fish. So we're not going to stress them out. But for those of you that have made it towards the end of the video here, just a couple kind of quick housekeeping things for you. As you can see, the fish room, the rack of 55s, I finally got this thing set back up. That tank there is actually empty. I put a kind of posed a question on my community tab asking what people think that I should put in there, but I'd love to have you guys give me your opinions as well. Let me know down below what you want to see in that 55-gallon. We have a lot of room over here to do some stuff, so I got some big things coming there. Again, I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I'm looking at getting a giant catfish for that pool pond upstairs. I lost a bet. That's going to be a video, so lots of cool stuff coming up. So if you have not already, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Give this video the thumbs up if you want to see me get shocked by a catfish. And yeah, as always, I appreciate you guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for growing this channel to what it is now. And until the next video, I will see you soon.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you soon. See you soon.